believe that in my life, the way that I smile at people, the way that I move, that I am really a billboard for God's love that the world needs to see. And I expect, I believe, that God's going to start putting people in my life for me to say, ah, sweetheart, you don't cashier. Ah, sweetheart, don't worry. Jesus loves you so much. Just that he will bring people to you that need to see your face and experience your love. And tonight, I believe he wants to give all of us that confidence that we can say, okay, Papa, I'm in. I'm all in until I breathe my last. And when I'm not in, you just pull me back in, Papa. Are we good at that?
Yeah. Yeah.
Amen. Okay, praise God. So I want to touch on the key to living in the anointing, to staying in this anointing. It's up to us. Like, I mean, God's the one who gives us the goods, but we have to go to the well. We get to drop our bucket. We get to get filled. It's divine intimacy. So it's just like divine intimacy. Literally, divine intimacy. Divine intimacy. Three times. Ready? One, two, three.
Divine intimacy.
Divine
intimacy. Divine intimacy.
Taste it. Taste it. Taste it. Divine intimacy. You know, Jesus, how it says to the apostles when they first are checking her out, come and see. See. Perceive. Taste. Experience the goodness of God. He's in you. He loves that right now you're saying the word divine intimacy. Yeah, this is it. This is my joy. Say it again. Taste it. Because he made you for divine intimacy. He loves when you go to prayer. He says, yes, got my daughter now. Not that he doesn't have you all day long, but when we have that face-to-face covenant time, any husband and wife will say amen to that. Divine intimacy, ready? Divine intimacy. Divine intimacy. Divine intimacy. The Bible ends with a wedding. Three more times. Divine intimacy. Divine intimacy. Divine intimacy. Because of the time, I'm not going to go through every single point in the tips for divine intimacy. They're in that handout. Raise your hand if you're slightly disappointed at what I just said. Raise your hand. Raise your hand. Your face said it all. Okay, I'm going to run through. So thank you. We need our sisters in Christ and brothers to help us know. And you just went off the reservation, Father. It's the most important thing, divine intimacy. So did I read your mind? No, I didn't read your mind. The face is like, do it. Okay, good? Divine intimacy? Bring it on?
Yeah.
Alright, here we go. So Jesus says, if you remain in me, John chapter 15, 5:7-9, if you remain in me, and my words remain in you. Ask for whatever you want, and it will be done for you. By this is my Father glorified, that you bear much fruit and become my disciples. As the Father loves me, so I also love you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and remain in his love. So Jesus tells us to remain in his love. If you keep my words, if you keep my commandments, and to keep his words, he says, if you, truly I say to you, if you hear the voice of God, Jesus says, you'll know this, the truth, and the truth will set you free. To remain in him, to remain in his words, the scriptures, but everything he says to us. I like to keep, like, just in my top pocket all the time, a little note card. Of stuff I heard that morning in prayer. Like, so I can remember, like, what he's saying, what some of the words he's giving me. It's everything he says to us. The scriptures, our individual prayer lives, the things we've heard at Mass, like, just keeping the beloved, or the lover, we could say, on our hearts. God, remaining his word. And the gift of prayer. It's such a gift to take time with him. I can't remember, I think it was Francis de Sales, who said everybody needs a half hour of prayer every day. Like not collectively added up, but a half hour uninterrupted. Where you just, as best as able, if you have a bunch of, my mom had 7 babies in 10 years. Like, that wasn't gonna happen for a certain point in life. But a half hour of just listening to the Lord. Give him 15, it's 15, but I like to keep a journal and just sit with him and talk with him. And the catechism tells us it's the heart that prays. The heart. And the biblical notion of heart is it's the center of the person. The center of your thinking, your feeling, and your willing. St. Teresa of Lisieux had a beautiful definition of prayer. She said, for me, prayer is a gaze toward heaven. I turn my thoughts to God. That will affect my feelings and my desires. So to bring, take that time, just go in and tell him what's on your heart and your mind. The letter to the Romans chapter 9 says that our conscience has been joined to the Holy Spirit. The Catholic Church teaches our conscience for a baptized disciple is a sanctuary where we are alone with God. God speaks to us, gives us inspired thought, interlocutions, hearing the voice of the Lord speak to you through your conscience, into your heart. We were all given this gift when we were baptized. So talking with the Lord, asking questions, really works. This guy was walking through the church today, a security guard, and I just stopped. I was praying Divine Mercy Chapel, and I sat there, and I sat back for a minute, and I looked to him, and I just started to listen. Is there something you want to tell me, Lord? And the Lord began to talk about Stephen, and to tell him Stephen's going to be okay, and that this man, tell Stephen you love him. And so I went and called him and I just said, hey, do you have, are you married? I beat you around the bush. I should have just said, do you have a son named Stephen? He said, yeah. And Stephen, and then I said, do you have a Stephen? And Stephen is his son-in-law. And I said, how's he doing? He said, bad. He drinks too much. He smokes too much. He's worried about his health. I just said, okay. I prayed with it for a minute and said, tell him. We bumped into a minister in church with a word from the Lord. Tell him he's going to be okay. And then tell him, Dan, that you love him. And that if he asks Jesus tonight to free him from this stuff and to heal him of this stuff, it'll happen. His father and mother, his stepfather, to call him and say, hey, this happened. The Lord wants you to know you're going to be okay. I love you. And if you ask Jesus tonight to free you from these things and to heal you, that's going to happen. We prayed for Dan that he'd be able to carry out the mission. It was in here. Sometimes we get it wrong. That's okay. It takes practice. Divine intimacy. The Lord truly speaks to us. That's what I'm getting at. And then honoring the friendship. Jesus is our friend. We're beloved sons and daughters of the Father. And we honor that relationship by giving God time. Any relationship will suffer. You know, any intimate relationship will suffer if we don't give it time. That's why I love to offer that half hour to anybody. So it's the heart. We bring out our heart, our thoughts, our feelings, our desires. We tell them what's going on. We listen. Catholic Church teaches that vocal prayer and meditation and contemplation are the three major forms of prayer. Just we can talk to the Lord. You can write it out in a journal if you want. Meditation is really chewing on things with Jesus. What happened there? Take something, you can take a line of scripture. I like to think of meditation as holy bubble gum. You can take a line of scripture and just start chewing on it. Or you can think about that bad conversation with your daughter and say, God, what, Jesus, what happened there? And just chew on it and start to think about it and let him take the faculties of your mind, move some things around and go, look at this. And that's revelation. And revelation brings joy. You go, it's awe and wonder when he gives you revelation. You say, well, you really do care about every hair on my head. It's awesome. The key to living in the anointing, you know you're full when you overflow, is intimacy, divine intimacy, going to the well. Contemplation, that's awesome. Catechism says it's the gaze of faith upon Jesus. The gaze of faith upon Jesus. You can think of it as well as the lover and the beloved. Just resting together. Those are simple little beautiful prayers. Jesus, I love you. Papa, I'm yours. And listen, you say it, Papa, I'm yours. And let the Father just say, I love you, son. Jesus, I love you. My heart is yours. I love you, daughter. Sorry, Father, say, I love you, daughter. Jesus, say, I love you. And then he'll just slip it in there. Don't be anxious anymore. Thank you, I needed to hear that. His whispers just raise us from the dead again and again. So vocal prayer, meditation, contemplation, adoration, to get in front of the Eucharist. Oh, just amazing to be in front of the Eucharist. There, I get stuck at Mass when I lift the Eucharist because there's just so much healing love pouring out. I can't tell you how many times in my own life, the problems I'm going through, whatever's on my mind, the healing happens when the consecration happens. I'm just, okay, thank you. It's awesome. You guys know what I'm saying? Amen. The consecration just like, let's show, like, when the consecration happens, here's all my wounds, you know? Make sure they're exposed. Like, so Father Andrew, if you see people at Sunday Mass going like this, during the consecration, it's okay. Maybe once or twice. Okay, so.